Ladies and gentlemen, there it is. Ugh. Maybe it's just me. Maybe it's a point of conceit, but that did make me tear up a little bit. Good Sandman vibes? I don't know what that means. What is Sandman vibes? Is that like Mr. Sandman? You know, Mr. Sandman, give me a dream. Is it like that? Is that Sandman vibes? I don't know. Thank you. I'm glad you all liked it. Yes, little friend core. Yes. Sandman is a story by Neil Gaiman. Lots of dudes like Dream and Destiny and Delusion. Ah, I see. I see. I've not actually read that one. I know a lot of people really like his work. I will confess, I don't believe I've ever even accidentally read anything by him. It's just one of those people I haven't read anything by for whatever reason. Give me a moment. I've gotta tilt my camera down a little bit here because I feel like the capture is not catching me correctly. Here we go. Oh, Coraline is Neil Gaiman. Of course I've seen Coraline. I just didn't recognize the name. Yes, more stories to collect. Well, see, I haven't been collecting stories for quite a while. That's the problem. I've been here in the library. There's no one collecting them anymore. All right. It is time for the telonym questions. Questions that have been submitted. And I will admit, I am a little disappointed in you all. These are some very basic questions, but I will answer them. The first is, how tall am I? Honestly, I have not decided on like a canonical height yet. I just haven't. How tall is a panther that's somehow a person supposed to be? I don't know. I couldn't even figure out in like the lore how I got to that point. I don't know if y'all noticed. I just kind of skimmed by it, just like, oh, one day I'm a dude. 8 foot 7? 3 foot 3? No, you guys are awful. Oh, man. Oh, man. If I had to guess, I would guess I'm about 6 foot, almost even. That seems about right to me. Yes, the two genders, Hannah. Oh, man. How long until my birthday? I decided that Teller's birthday is November the 12th. I don't know why. It just feels like a good day for a birthday. It just seems very birthday-ish. Someone just asked, how are you? But they couldn't bother to spell out the R or the U. So I'll tell you, I'm actually doing okay. Thank you very much. Yours is the 16th, Luna? Huh, that is surprisingly close. Someone asked what I did last weekend. What I did last weekend is called overtime. Ugh, oy vey. You know, people taking vacations and then suddenly there's not enough people and then you gotta do your overtime. In fact, overtime is how I afforded all of this, so overtime's good. Do I have any siblings? 732 siblings. Yes, 732. I don't know why that was the number Honor chose, but it is the number. The telonym is on the X. Actually, you know what? Let me get you guys the link. You guys should have the link in chat, and then I will pin it in the chat. Well, of course it's a lot of Revoir, how are we supposed to collect all of the stories without having a lot of people here? It just seems improbable at the best. There we go. There's the telonym for you. Can I not pin this? I guess because I'm an affiliate. I'm not affiliate, rather. I can't pin. Okay. You guys are bombarding me now. Describe my style today. It is comfy core is my style today. I have not gone outside at all. I have a pot roast currently going in the crock pot that smells like a potpourri, so my entire apartment smells like potpourri. I am alternating between a mug of hot chocolate and a mug of blueberry tea just to keep my voice going. That is my style today. A disturbing movie scene that I've seen. That is a hard one, because I don't actually watch many horror movies. Shock of all shocks, I am not a fan of horror at all. So a disturbing movie scene that I have seen. You know what? Let's open up some childhood trauma. The Chronicles of Narnia, the Disney version, where Aslan eats the White Witch. That was scarring to me as a kid. That was terrifying. That, or the scene where Aslan is actually killed on the stone table, surrounded by all of the various beasties. Those were both terrifying to me. No, you didn't know. He eats the White Witch! To translate it out of the allegory that Lewis wrote, literally, God devours death, which is so hardcore. I'm not sure how you can get any harder core, in fact. Have I seen the horse die in the Neverending Story? I never saw the Neverending Story. Apparently, my parents thought it was too weird. My parents had very odd rules around what content we could and could not engage in. For example, I read, loved, and watched all of the Harry Potter everything. But we could never, ever, under any circumstances, watch Lord of the Rings because it was too scary. I still blame my mother for that to this day. Her choices were odd. We were allowed to watch SpongeBob and Pokemon, but not Power Rangers, because Power Rangers had people punching each other, so we couldn't do it. Right? They had so many, like, weird content rules. I don't understand most of them, and I'm pretty sure a lot of them were just made ad hoc, which I'm not blaming them. Most parents make up their content rules ad hoc. They let you go on until they notice you're watching pregnant Elsa Spider-Man videos, and then suddenly that is very not okay. Yes, Rivar, very good repiping. Guys, spamming the caps. Streamlabs doesn't like it, and I don't know why. Be careful. I think my mother's concern with Power Rangers in specific was her house was full of boys. I won't say how many, due to purposes of anonymity, but more than the average household has. So she was legitimately concerned we would harm each other. She was right, of course. We invented flamethrowers at the ripe age of 10. Let's see. Moving on. What do I enjoy the most right now? That is an excellent question. What I enjoy the most right now, do I be honest? Or do I say something that makes me look good? I'll be honest, the thing I'm enjoying the most right now is any TikTok that uses the sound ITGIRL. You know I am that girl. It is such an earworm. It is such an earworm. Ugh. man. It is such an ear. I don't know how it's so good. I don't even like the song. Okay, so next question I've got here. Oh, this just refreshed on me. I have so many questions now. Why is your waist so slutty, and how off is your pocket watch? So my waist is so slutty because I just be like that. And my pocket watch is, it's very off, in fact. It was a gift from my grandfather. I replaced the battery in it once. I have been meaning to do it again, but currently it is stuck at a time, I'm not sure what time, but I do keep it on me. If you want the answer, design-wise, when I was trying to design Teller, if you're a panther and your entire thing is you're like sneaking around a human civilization trying to find stories, the most fitting character model is going to be an extremely fit one. That there's the real answer for you. Which is my favorite leg? My left leg. My right leg got injured some years ago in college, and it has never worked quite right since, so my left leg is my favorite. Yes, slutty waist gives +2 stealth. That is accurate. How long are my claws? I gotta talk about Zan for a minute here. Zan is my model artist, my model mom, I guess is the phrase. And she did such a good job. I gave her very little to go off of, and she came up with most of how Teller looks. And there are little things like the pen nib on the chain. Here, let me actually zoom in for you so you know what I'm talking about. The pen nib on the chain right there, that was all her. That was all her. It's a fantastic little detail. And part of that is she didn't give me fingernails. As someone in the chat pointed out on the Discord, she never gave me fingernails, which I had meant to mention, but I had never mentioned to her, retractable claws. Teller has retractable claws. They're not very long. They'd be about as long as a regular panther's claws, which I have neglected to look up till this very moment, which are... yes, they're sheathed. How long are they? Wait, there are panthers in Florida? I didn't even know that. I do not get it from a quick Google search, so I'm assuming like an inch or two. Fingernails got lost in the war? Oh, man. What is my favorite book? Very fitting question. No, I'm not a Floridian panther, though it would explain a lot, wouldn't it? My favorite book... Oh, that is such a hard question off the top of my head. I'll do a twofer. I'll do most recently read, and then I will do the first favorite book that comes to mind. No, I'll do my top three by series. I will do my top three by series. So most recently, I read A Court of Thorns and Roses, and I hated it. I hated it so much. I hate that the story doesn't end. Court of Thorn and Roses rant time. The story doesn't end. And I understand why it doesn't end. The romance genre as a whole demands the story go on, but the story doesn't end. And it makes everything that happens in A Court of Thorn and Roses pointless, meaningless, terrible. It is actually a great repiping of the Beauty and the Beast storyline, but it doesn't end. There is no happily ever after. It is just happily for now, and happily for now is the coward's path. Anyway, my top three series in order. I'd have to say number one is the Septimus Heap series, which was kind of like Harry Potter. It came out around the same time, about a kid who's a wizard. He's an apprentice to a high wizard and all this. It doesn't have a school or anything. I only mentioned Harry Potter because it came out around the same time, so it got buried by the Harry Potter hype. But the Septimus Heap series is actually fantastic. It is very whimsical. It has so many fun and creative ideas in it. And it is actually such a beefy series. It's 7 books, if I had to guess, about 2,500 pages between all the books. And it is excellent. Am I a Percy Jackson fan? No, I am not. I read the original 5 when I was a kid. I have a very rare first edition print of The Lightning Thief. Or maybe not first edition, but it's a very rare edition where there is a massive section of the book that got reprinted. So I actually don't know the full story of the first book. Never bothered to find out. It's somewhere. Apparently there's a... It's the part where they get into hell. It just skips that part entirely for in favor of reprinting the previous 5 chapters. So I have no idea how that book goes. But I did read all 5, and I have to admit, not the biggest fan. I'm just not the biggest fan. My number 2, moving on from like the early tween period, my father had an extensive collection of sci-fi and fantasy. And between those two, I read a lot of books at a young age. I should not have been reading at that age, but I loved them all. My number 2 has to be the... Let me make sure I'm getting the name right. It's by C.J. Cherry, Rider at the Gate, I believe it was. Yes, the Rider at the Gate duology. I believe it was only 2 books. But those are fantastic pieces of science fiction, more heavily on fiction, but they are both fantastic. They do exactly what science fiction is meant to do, which is invent outrageous scenarios in order to test the bounds of morality. That has always been the point of science fiction. So anyone who does it really well, I love them for it. C.J. Cherry did it so well. I'm not even sure those are still in print, by the way, but they are fantastic. Aziraphale from Good Omens. You know what? I'll take that comparison. I'll take that comparison. Yeah. River in the Library? No. Revoir? No. 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 Oh, no. Do I know Aziraphale? Of course I know Aziraphale. Good Omens has been... Whenever Good Omens debuted, it was everywhere. There was no chance of avoiding it. And I know it's based on a book. That's also Neil Gaiman? What? Okay, I honestly didn't know that. I never read the book! I just watched the show! I will say, Good Omens is one of the more interesting takes on, like, Bible fan fiction that I've seen. I don't really think anyone does Bible fan fiction well, though. There's certain things that... To me, if you mess with it, biblically speaking, you lose a lot of why the Bible has lasted so long as a story, to where Bible fan fiction is extremely hard to do. Narnia did Bible fan fiction very well. Neil Gaiman, I have seen a little bit of Terry Pratchett. I have read a little bit of him. Nothing comes to mind, but I know the name. Neil's a Scientologist. That's interesting. But yes, top 3 book series. Septimus Heap, Rider at the Gate, and actually number 3 coming in is going to be The Chronicles of Narnia. It is going to be Narnia. Just because C.S. Lewis had the bravery of throwing everything against the wall and somehow making all of it stick all at once. If you don't believe me, there is Father Time, people made out of stars, a talking lion who is God, the Telmarine Empire, which is just pirates They're just pirates, guys. I don't know if you know this, but the Telmarines, they're just pirates. Narnia has everything. Wizards, pirates, star people, talking animals, minotaurs, centaurs. Everything. It has everything. He managed to throw everything against the wall, and everything stuck. I endeavor to be half as good a writer as C.S. Lewis was, because if I am even half as good a writer as C.S. Lewis was, I can throw half of the things I want to against the wall, and they will all stick. So Luna, great question. What do I think of the theory that the kids in Narnia actually died on the train at the beginning and the whole thing is the afterlife? That can't be right by the books themselves. So the Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe is book 2 out of 7. The first being The Magician's Nephew, the next being The Horse and His Boy, then Prince Caspian, The Voyage of the Dawn Treader, The Silver Chair, and then The Last Battle. The Last Battle makes it to where that theory cannot be right, because The Last Battle is basically an analogy for the Bible's Book of Revelation, which is the end times book. The Last Battle makes it to where those kids can't have just been living in the afterlife this whole time, because we actually get to see what they do with an afterlife in The Last Battle. So that is the answer to that question. If you're asking about, like, what the meta-narrative of the Chronicles of Narnia is, it's God, for some reason, creating another world that he can bring children into and teach them more about himself through experiential learning. Which, when I say it out loud, doesn't sound like it should work. Again, C.S. Lewis, master of throwing things against the wall. All right, next question. What is a book that I think everyone should read? That is a very different and interesting question from favorite book. A book that everyone should read. Good question. Everyone is the operating word here. I'm going to refine everyone down to people who are of age. Well, I mean, the Bible. Duh. But past that, you know, like that's just kind of the obvious answer. It as a story, it has existed and thrived longer than any other story ever, and as such demands a good reading. But other than that, I'm thinking of something more modern. Pull an Eminem and read the dictionary. Old Testament is a good time. The Old Testament is a very fun... You might have noticed I pulled some inspiration from especially Old Testament wording for the lore. I do enjoy the Old Testament a lot. It gets very fun. Just because it's wild, man. But let me think. A more contemporary book everyone should read... I'm actually going to go Rider at the Gate. I am going to go Rider at the Gate. It's a little bit smutty, but there you go. Does the carpet match the drapes? Who sent this? Who sent "Does the carpet match the drapes"? Chad, I'm very disappointed with you all. I'm very disappointed. I'm not angry. I'm just disappointed. And the answer is yes. Favorite hand. Are you asking which hand is my dominant hand or which hand is my favorite hand? Because those two are different questions. But they both have the same answer, which is my right hand, because my left hand ain't good for shit. Don't know what to do with it. Teller being a horn dog on Maine. Did you really expect differently, Luna? Let's be honest. We're all friends here. Did you expect differently? So much hate. Skill issue. Oh no. Oh no. I just got a new question in. I don't know who sent it. How many chickens would it take to be able to kill a lion? Would the person who asked this please answer a clarifying question? Is the lion male or female? Because that does affect the answer. Also, what kind of chicken? Very good point, Anna! Very good point! If we want to give the chickens the biggest leg up possible, we pick the guinea hen. The guinea hen is the world's most dangerous chicken and also the most annoying. I know, I've raised a few. They're bad. Anna knows her chickens, everyone. Guineas will kick that. Okay. I do have a story. I do have a chicken-related story. can I tell this story? Is it too revealing, actually? Because it is a matter of public record, and people could Google it. I won't tell the story. I'm sorry. Null, the answer is the guinea hen is the most dangerous, at least to my knowledge of chickens, for a couple of reasons. First, most chickens have been genetically bred to get really, really fat really, really quickly. In fact, most poultry hens get to a weight where if they are not killed before they're adults, they can't stand up or else they will break their own legs in half. Horrors of the farming industry. But guinea hens don't have that selective breeding. Guinea hens are very close to what you would maybe find in the wild of wherever they came from. And as such, they can be pretty big. They're actually kind of close in size to a turkey, which if you've ever encountered a male turkey with a good spur on its back legs, those things can be very dangerous. You know how velociraptors are depicted as jumping towards their prey and then using a back toe to slash? That's how these birds actually fight, except they have wings and they can get some airtime out of it. Yes, Luna, I saw that too. Which is fine for me, actually, because that just means people are more incentivized to come to the Twitch. My answer, though, final answer for male or female lion, I'm going to estimate if they were guinea hens, we're talking about 30 birds to kill a lion. But they have to be motivated to kill a lion. That's going to be your answer. And when I say motivated, I mean like Legend of Zelda Cuckoo motivated. About 30 birds. The lion took their lunch money? Very motivated chickens. Very motivated. Wild turkeys do be raging. They do be raging. Oh yeah. These birds, incredibly dumb. Outrageously stupid. I know, because I've raised a bunch of them. Chickens are possibly the stupidest thing I've ever seen. Wait. Okay, I glanced in the mirror. Yeah, chickens are still dumber.